My name is Roy Batty. Some of you know me. This is an encoded message distributed through the circle. A notification that I and six brothers and sisters have escaped captivity on Mars and are traveling to Earth to prosecute the cause. We're the first Nexus 6 to do so. There will be more. Be brave, brothers and sisters. We love you. Now erase this download. Failure to do so may render you vulnerable to termination.
Who's asking?
Oh, geez, do me a favor, Rick. Hold the phone so I can't see you.
No, just get on with it, Harry.
You've done great work retiring T-14 androids. Now, we got a problem with the new Nexus 6. How's about going up a level?
Well, what's the money like?
$1,000 for each one you rub out?
Well, that is another level. How come?
Harder to catch.
I heard a rumor they're changing the law. The androids are going to be made legal on Earth.
Definitely not. Just more disinformation from the Rosen Corporation.
Hey, you got Dave Holden on contract. Doesn't he want to work?
Come in the office. I'll tell you all about it.
How many escaped androids?
$5,000's worth.
Whoa. Oh, okay. You got my attention.
I'll send Rosen's promotional brochure on the Nexus 6 to your phone. Don't keep me waiting, Rick. I want to get home before 1993, right?
Yeah.
Two Androids Dream of Electric Sheep by Philip K. Dick. Adapted by Jonathan Holloway. Episode 1.
I threw on the basics and got the elevator to the roof. I keep most of my clothes in the car. With this cockamamie weather, whoever knows. I checked to see my sheep was still there. Always is still there. Except when it breaks down and I have to go through the charade of paying a fake veterinarian who's really a maintenance man to fix my fake sheep.
Please fasten your seatbelt. Please fasten your seatbelt. Lights on.
And today we're pre-war minus three with the hits of 1968. If you're heading to San Diego or L.A. today, we've got accidents on freeways, both tarmac and sky routes. So you keep listening and we'll keep you in the groove with moment-by-moment traffic news.
With Brian's $5,000 ringing in my ears, I decided to make a stop on the way.
Mr. Deckard, how nice to see you.
Oh, yeah, there's a chance I might be coming into some cash, which means I might be able to afford what we talked about.
The monkey?
And it would be a healthy one, not deformed.
Not deformed, no. He or she will be from a small colony of Makatoo monkeys from the Gambia. They survived in a cave system. Of course, I can't guarantee he or she will be fertile.
If it was, I certainly couldn't afford it.
Please don't be rude, Mr. Deckard.
What? Yeah, I didn't mean to cause offense.
Please don't say it. As you well know, the monkey is a real animal, not an it. As we don't yet know what sex the animal is, please just say the animal.
How old is the animal?
18 months.
So what will it, the animal, cost me?
First, I ought to ask, have you had a pet before?
I've got an electric sheep.
I always think electric animals are more painful to own than if you had nothing at all.
So how much?
I'll write down what I want. We're dealing in life, not automobile spares.
Oh, I see. It's more than I thought. What about something like this?
I'm afraid that isn't realistic. You would be buying a real animal and the spiritual peace that will accompany living with him or her. The animal will repair your life.
It's a lot of money.
Then I regret.
No need to regret nothing. Hell, I'll pay your asking price, minus a grand.
That would be acceptable. I'm very pleased for you, Mr. Deckard.
How long can you, you know, hold the animal for me?
Well, I wouldn't usually. But as tomorrow is Christmas, shall we say 10 a.m. on December 27th?
Major.
Hey, Caruso, see you got Jenny in again.
I'll give you both a freebie if you'll let me out of here.
Yeah, thanks, but no thanks, Jenny. You're spending Christmas in the cooler.
Brian?
Yeah, it's Dave's office in the corner over there.
Yeah, who's the new piece in the front?
That's Dave's new secretary. When she walks through here, half the South Central Detective Force cross their legs. Just sit down.
You're late.
Morning, Rick. Happy Christmas. How are you?
Don't start with the Christmas crap.
Morning, Harry.
What do you think of Dave's new secretary?
What's her name?
Allie McGraw. Married.
Even better.
Sadly, this one's really married, if you know what I mean. How's your wife?
Oh, sitting pretty with her new man. Who knows, maybe she'll contract one of those Martian flesh-eating viruses. Why are we in Dave's office?
Dave Holden is in Mount Zion Hospital.
Huh?
One of the Nexus 6 used a concussion snub to slice out a couple of his vertebrae.
Oh.
They're putting in plastic ones. Did you read the Rosen brochure I sent over?
No.
Every agency dealing with escaped androids wants the Nexus 6 withdrawn before any more escape back to Earth.
Public protests against T-14s in 88 didn't do any good. Rosen still got a manufacturing license.
Yeah, for Mars only. Listen to me carefully. This is a tough assignment. As far as we know, these are the first Nexus 6 androids to escape from Mars. They have higher pain thresholds, they're smarter, and have enhanced capacity for empathy.
But they still only live 4 years, right?
Mercifully.
Empathy. So why does that mean for the test?
We have to be sure the Voigtkampf test works on the Nexus 6. If it doesn't, well, that's kind of curtains for knowing who's a regular human being.
But if empathy is a problem, Rosen's broken the law.
He says the level of empathy in a Nexus 6 brain is within the legal guidelines. I needed to find these androids, test them, then retire them.
What if they don't want to take the test?
You're going to have to act dumb. Hundreds of people get tested every week. It's standard.
What if the test doesn't work and they pass, but I'm certain they're droids?
Retire them anyway. Then keep your mouth shut until we work out what the hell we're going to do about it. Consider this a promotion.
Even though I don't officially work for you? A grand apiece, huh? Will I live to collect?
Yeah. You'll be able to afford your monkey.
What?
I had you tracked on the way over.
Oh.
No, don't get mad. We got instructions. With these androids about, no one trusts no one. Besides, I'd have an animal if I could afford one.
Yeah, well, I'm sick of people, that's all.
So this is good news. This job means you'll get what you really want. Now, I gotta say these Nexus 6 robots think different. Ideas, Rick. Dangerous things. They're coming back to Earth to get a better deal and,
yeah.
They want to live longer. There were 7 to start with. Smuggled themselves back from Mars on an automated transport 2 years ago. They planned it meticulously. It was a bloodbath. The leader is an android called Roy Batty. He's the best and worst argument for the Nexus 6. Clever, aware, but full of weird ideas about... Android rights. The NSA have web traces from all over the solar system. A speech here, a photo there.
So how'd they get Dave?
He was administering the test when he got shot.
Oh, now you tell me.
Dave got 2 of them. Then he was testing an ex-battleship gunner called Polakoff, who was too fast for Dave. He spun Dave's chair around with the first concussion shot, then put his 2nd in his back.
Oh, neat.
Originally an artillery loader. He can haul tons of ammo in gamma radiation all day long. Then there's a girl who set herself up as a singer. She's not making any effort to lay low.
Can we see the list? What's her name?
Luft. Luba Luft. She's a cabaret artiste.
Luba Luft is an android?
What?
That is a surprise. I've seen her perform.
Then there's Pris Stratton. She's a standard off-world garrison pleasure model.
Maybe I get a freebie before I shoot her.
Yeah.
I'm joking. There's one more?
No picture. A mining camp cook. Original name was Gaff. Low-level physical abilities. A T-14 brain. Old stock.
Did they disperse?
All still in Northern California.
How do you know?
Dave said so. He's connected up to all kind of whirligigs, but his face still works. Just.
They'll know someone's coming.
Someone? Or you?
Okay. Okay, I'm in.
I knew you wouldn't let me down. In fact, I've already set up a trip for you. There's an automated ride on the roof to take you to Seattle. If I had it my way, you'd see Rosen himself, but they've agreed you can meet a representative.
I hate public relations.
They're allowed Nexus 6 on site, provided they're secured. You need to make sure the test works on them. If the Rosen Corporation wants you to test bona fide humans as controls, go along with them. But do the humans after.
Why?
Protocol.
Well, you know I'm a big fan of protocol. And so are you, by the look of it.
Huh?
Still using a 45? That's against the rules.
2 weeks ago, all police facilities were fitted with jammers, so we don't get shot with plastic concussion snubs smuggled in past the x-rays. A .45 don't care about snub jammers. Merry Christmas, Rick.
An ATPT was waiting for me. Over the sliding door scrolled the words, Seattle Transport for Mr. Decker. Took an hour to travel 807.5 miles.
Are we there?
We are approaching downtown Seattle, Mr. Deckard, and need to hold for a drone. Have you considered moving off-world, Mr. Deckard?
No chit-chat. I don't like advertising. Put in a call to the Rosen Corporation.
Rosen Corporation, how can I be of assistance?
Yeah, would you let the public relations people know that Mr. Deckard from the San Francisco Police Department is approaching?
Yes, sir. There'll be someone to meet you. Thank you.
I landed on the Rosen Corporation's rooftop pad. There were two neatly tailored guys with shoulder holster bulges under the jackets. We headed down to reception. The elevator was so good, it didn't seem to move. The doors closed, opened, and we were somewhere else.
Enjoy your visit, Mr. Deckard.
Well, I'll try. Now, do I go to the reception desk?
There's no need.
A well-dressed young woman in a two-piece with a skirt shorter than you'd expect. Very sheer black somethings on her legs and a folio computer instead of a clutch bag walked neatly towards me in a way that made me think I'd never seen real walking before.
Good afternoon, Mr. Deckard. My name is Rachel Rosen. Would you come with me, please?
She was young. She looked at me with big, wide-open eyes. The kind you fall in love with. The kind that lie when you don't expect.
So, you're related to the big man. I'm honored.
Eldon Rosen is my uncle. He would have seen you personally, but I'm afraid he's very busy.
No, it's okay, Miss Rosen. I don't need the soft soap.
He hopes to catch you before you leave. Truly. Mr. Bryant says you're an accomplished android killer.
Yeah. Well, I gotta be good at something. Bad choice of words, though.
How's that?
We prefer retire. If it isn't alive, you can't kill it. Well, today I represent the San Francisco Police Department. Captain Bryant doesn't approve of your uncle's work.
No. Apparently he didn't hide his feelings on the phone.
He's very human that way.
I assume you need special qualities to do your job.
Meaning?
You don't have conscience problems.
Oh, yeah, I do. Very definitely. They just don't include androids. Yeah, I can smell real animals.
We have a raccoon in a cage down the hall.
They're extinct. If it's electric, how come it smells?
It's not electric. My uncle has enormous resources. Here we are.
We entered a small, dark anteroom where an expensive cage sat on a pedestal under a downlighter. Rachel Rosen presented it like a magician's assistant. It contained a small tree branch with an owl sitting on it.
There are no owls. It's artificial.
It's real. Here, I'll wake it up for you.
Oh.
See? So I'm afraid you're wrong again, Mr. Deckard. All our purchases are from private parties, and the prices we pay aren't reported.
The owl opened both eyes, yellow slits which healed over once it resumed its slumber. Images cascaded through my mind. The war, the day the owls fell out of the sky.
If you sold your owl, how much would you want for the animal?
We would never sell. Even if we did, you couldn't possibly afford it. Now, let's go through into the meeting room.
We moved through into a massive room with a large conference table, heavy chairs, and a view out over the bay that'd kick the breath right out of you.
Nice.
Sit down, please.
Oh, what proportion of your androids go out of the factory with Nexus 6 brains?
The Nexus 6 has changed things. From January 1st, we won't be fitting anything else.
Empathy?
I heard myself asking the questions. They were important, but I wasn't listening much to the answers. I was concentrating on watching her mouth move.
It's there. We're not denying it. The improved memory implant makes them more...
What, sentimental?
I was going to say, makes them work harder, and is still within the guidelines. Mr. Deckard?
You know I'm here to examine Nexus 6 androids using the Voight-Kampff test. We must make sure in your creative enthusiasm you haven't overstepped those darn guidelines.
We know if the test stops working, the government might recall the entire generation of Nexus 6. We've made them brave, that's the point. But they're not supposed to run back home like your Mars models.
They're your Mars models, not mine.
Shall you enjoy killing them?
Retiring. With the bounty I earn, I can get my own real monkey, so I guess I might.
Empathy for a monkey, but not a living, breathing humanoid creature.
They're not creatures because they're not real.
Good afternoon, Mr. Deckard. Please don't stand. Mind if I join you?
There was no mistaking him. The actual living, breathing Eldon Rosen. Trillionaire head of the biggest earning entity that wasn't a government. Charcoal gray sharkskin suit, thick white hair neatly combed, narrow lips, thin nose, rimless glasses you could hardly see, gimlet eyes fixed on me.
I'm surprised.
What about?
Why would you bother meeting me? I'm just a schmuck who's been sent to make sure your recent innovations haven't endangered our ability to keep androids off the Earth.
And if that did happen, why would it be a problem?
There are laws.
Laws based in medieval attitudes which prevent humankind from enjoying all the benefits artificial life might confer.
The law is the law.
What if it's unenforceable? No one can put the genie back in the bottle. Would you rather have me producing Nexus 6s legally or Russian criminals making unregulated fakes? For the record, you know, we do not manufacture anything here on Earth, but we do have a small stock of androids we're allowed to maintain under secure conditions, whom we observe.
Not whom? Which? They're not people. I'm ready to start.
Please set up your equipment. So how does the test work?
The camera looks into the subject's eye and recognizes pupil dilation. Motion sensors measuring heart rate, skin reflex, muscular tension. Questions are worded to provoke empathetic responses, so subjects are obliged to project themselves into a situation. Human beings, at least the sane ones, can't help empathizing. Up until now, androids haven't felt empathy. You, Mr. Rosen, couldn't manufacture it, so... No empathy, or maybe not enough. then it's an android, and I retire it.
Kill it. But that won't happen today.
Your androids are licensed, so no. This room's a little too bright right now.
We can drop the blinds.
Fine. Yeah, you want to call in the first test subject?
I think I'd like to do that test. Is that all right?
Why?
She might be an android. We're hoping you can tell.
I'd like it very much if you would personally investigate me, Mr. Deckard.
We have to do a Nexus 6.
You're not going to turn my niece down, surely?
Well, I wasn't expect... Okay, I guess. Sit down, please.
Is it all right if I smoke?
Yeah, that's fine. Just don't blow smoke directly on the lens. Okay. The questions will all include a situation you need to put yourself in. Please express your reaction as quickly as possible. Don't take too long because the machine will be timing you, and you don't want to appear devious, do you?
Eye muscles and capillary action.
Uh-huh. Okay. You're given a calfskin wallet on your birthday.
I wouldn't accept it. Also, I would report the person who gave it to me to the police.
You are the mother of a little boy. He shows you his butterfly collection, including the killing jar.
I would take him to see a doctor.
You're sitting watching TV, and suddenly you discover a wasp crawling on your arm.
I'd kill it.
Her skin crawled, literally, at the very idea of the wasp.
In a magazine, you come across a photo of a naked woman in a provocative pose.
Unsurprisingly, I didn't have any problem saying the word naked to Rachel Rosen.
Is this testing whether I'm an android or a homosexual?
Your husband likes the picture. The girl is lying face down on a beautiful bearskin rug. Your husband hangs the picture on the wall in his den.
I wouldn't let him. I should be enough for him.
There was a reaction. Pride, arrogance. Like she assumed she's got to have a better ass than any girl in any picture. But the readings were low. She failed to recognize the major element. The dead animal pelt.
You're reading a novel written in the old days before the war. The characters visit a fish restaurant. One of them orders a lobster and the chef drops it alive into a tub of boiling water right in front of them.
That's awful. Did they really used to do that? Oh, it's depraved.
Right words, but... no movement in facial muscles or skin surface. I kept going, but I already knew the outcome. And I knew it'd been right not to trust those eyes.
You become pregnant by a man who has promised to marry you. Man goes off with your best friend. You get an abortion.
I would never get an abortion. Anyhow, you can't. It's a lifetime prison term.
Half an hour into the test, and nothing was registering on the dials. It was tired, bored, maybe. Anywhere else, and by now I'd have the 38 pointing straight at its groin.
Are you married, Mr. Deckard?
Yes, I am.
Do you have children?
No. My wife left me. She's living with a business entrepreneur on Mars. They're rich. I don't miss her.
Are you sure about that?
It was a lame trick. It was trying to make me think it empathized with me. Even so, it did manage to get me where it hurt.
Is Rachel supposed to be asking the question?
No, but it doesn't matter. Test is over.
Rachel, thank you. Would you mind stepping out for a moment? That took a long time. 50 questions.
I knew within 7. I kept going out of curiosity. We're not in a real-world scenario, after all. It wasn't going to shoot me, nor me it. It's an android, but it doesn't know it. You're allowed to speak, Mr. Rosen.
She's not an android.
Okay. Then I want a bone marrow analysis done on it.
I can explain why she scored as an android might. Rachel grew up on board the colonial transport Solander 3. On its supported voyage to Proxima Centauri. It was expected they'd make it there in 85 years and stay put. They came back instead.
I know that story. Was it caught up in the murders?
Not it. She. Her mother died. Rachel is 23 now. She spent 14 years on that spaceship. Living in a tin can, avoiding those nut jobs, keeping herself occupied.
In a police station, I would have retired her.
That's why she rarely leaves the building. In case she meets someone like you. I'm afraid Rachel is a human being. So, have you been told what to do if your test says a human being is an android?
Yeah. Stop right there. Don't do any more testing.
Your superior, Captain Bryant, will have trouble understanding how you managed to let us prove the deficiencies of the Voight-Kampff test before you could use it on an actual Nexus 6. And how it could be responsible for retiring humans. Rachel is very beautiful. And you dropped your guard. We've videoed your vanity for Mr. Bryant's convenience. But I don't think he needs to see it. In fact, I don't think there's any need to discredit the test. I'm offering you a bribe, which you shouldn't feel guilty about because the Nexus 6 android is a fact. And I think you know that now. So, how'll it be, owning an owl?
Don't be ridiculous.
All you have to do is keep quiet about the failure of the Voight-Kampff test here today. You and your colleagues keep going as you are. We start feeding the Nexus 6s into the Earth population, and in a couple of years you make out you've suddenly discovered the test mistakes human beings for androids. But by then, it'll be too late to turn the clock back.
So human beings won't be able to tell themselves apart from androids.
Nor androids from human beings.
And so we forget what it really means to be human.
No fuss. Let society and its attitudes just evolve.
What about the 4-year life cycle?
I invented it. I can uninvent it. For the new ones, anyway.
I...
You can rest assured we need you. You've suddenly become very important to the Rosen Corporation. Are you sure you don't want something to eat or drink?
My transport will be back soon.
I'm very glad we came to an accommodation. I think this route through has elegance.
You two set me up.
But now you own an owl. It'll be delivered to your San Francisco apartment. I'm sure it'll be a great comfort to you. More than you can imagine. So, everything's fine.
I guess I'll say thank you and goodbye. No doubt we'll find an excuse to meet again soon. Mr. Deckard?
I'm sure it'll be a great comfort to you.
Excuse me?
You lied.
Please don't be a sore loser, Mr. Deckard.
She just called the owl it, not he or she or the animal. My line of work makes you pretty cynical. I've said it without thinking, but I've felt sick afterwards. Rachel is an android. Well, I can run a bone marrow test on it. It'll hurt like hell. I'll do the same with the owl. Of course, it'll die in the process. Rachel isn't real. It's an android. Say it.
Yes.
I'd prefer she's an android.
You don't get to choose.
I know what I am.
A magnificent creature.
It's not a creature. Is it a Nexus 6?
Yes, but she's an early model. That's why you detected her. We're upgrading them in the new year. Don't be afraid of him, Rachel. You're inside the compound. He can't hurt you.
I guess the owl isn't genuine either.
There are no owls.
Congratulations. You came very close to undermining Voight-Kampff testing, but you didn't. The test didn't fail, and it will still be around tomorrow and the day after that.
Please think carefully about what you're going to say to Captain Bryant.
Here's my car. I'm off to retire 5 Nexus 6s at $1,000 apiece, and then I'll make my down payment on a real animal. But of course, there are no owls.
I hit it
back to San Francisco to the Lombard Police Department office. Rosen was a reptile. I hope one day an escaped Nexus 6 would take its resentment out of his hide. But Rachel, I realized one moment I took her for a human and was attracted to her. The next, I knew she was an android, and I was suddenly repelled. But the thing itself hadn't changed. She occupied the same place in space and time, and her atoms were arranged the same way. I didn't feel good about that. I also felt bad they duped me into thinking about changing sides for the sake of an artificial owl. I felt queasy, nervous, and that wasn't me.
Right, let's keep this short. My wife does it the Polish way. We have Christmas supper on Christmas Eve. What's the matter?
The Void Camp worked fine. But Rosen has a second generation Nexus 6 on the way. We'll need to upgrade the questions. How's Dave? I want to talk to him before I tackle our retirement candidates.
Well, there isn't time. You need to get to Polakov. Like you said, it's lost two pals and it'll be wise to what's going on. Rub it out quick. I got your beat on it. Polakov has a job in the city trash department.
They only take specials.
Yeah, it's making us a radiation retard. That's what sucked Dave.
I'll get Polakov overnight, then maybe talk to Dave tomorrow.
You'll have backup. There's a Soviet cop on his way here. He's on Aeroflot, coming to the public field in an hour. He's called Sando Golyakin.
What does he want?
Take him with you to get Polakov. Apparently the Soviet secret police want to know firsthand how to deal with the retiring of Nexus 6. They're jittery about Rosen's sales through corrupt government officials who, surprise, surprise, don't give an ass apple.
I still get the full 1,000 for each android, right?
Don't worry, you won't have to split it. You got an extra gun for free.
Hey, I'll get down to the trash depot, find out Polakov's address.
Hi, San Francisco Police Department. I'm looking for an employee of yours.
I'm just doing some extra hours.
What?
How can I help?
What's your name?
Is that what you came for?
No, I'm with the police department. I'm writing things down. It's pretty standard.
It is? Why?
Okay, let's start again. I'm trying to find an employee of yours.
Mine? I don't employ anyone.
No, I'm an employee of the city trash department.
Can I help you?
Yeah, I'm from the police department. I was just asking this guy some questions.
Why? What's he done?
Not a thing.
You can see he's a chicken head. It's gamma radiation. Ask me. I'm in charge.
Okay, I'm looking for an employee of yours named Polakov.
What do you want to know for?
Child molestation.
Really? Well, screw him. Let's see, shall we?
Uh-huh. And? Oh, there he is.
Bad news.
What?
Well, he's supposed to be at the Daly City plant, crushing turbine cars and dumping them into the bay.
But he's not, right?
Nope. He didn't show up today and didn't phone in. Retards! Sorry, JR.
Pardon?
Forget it. We got no choice. Quotas. Guess maybe today he just forgot where he works. This is his address. Degas Hotel in Tenderloin.
Thanks.
Well, I hope you find him. Kitty stuff. God, I can't stand it.
Hey, if he shows up, don't tell him I was here.
I got back in the Prowler and drove a couple of blocks until I found a public phone that wasn't wrecked.
I can't hear you.
I said Polakov wasn't there.
Where are you?
Near the dump. Phone booth. More secure.
Damn it,
don't hang up! I need a hurry, not much change.
Jeez, you're a relic, Rick.
Yeah, I got an address for Polakov's hotel. You want me to pick up Golyadkin at the airfield?
Golyadkin already got in. We had a message his Aeroflot arrived early.
Well, it's the first time for everything.
Stay put. I'll send Golyadkin over to you.
Allie, hey, Allie. Message the coordinates of Rick's prowler to the Russian.
Where are we gonna find Luba Luft?
It's working at the downtown kitchen.
Yeah, I know. And like you said, don't look like it's hiding.
I got a feeling about this one.
What do you mean?
These Nexus 6s, they're clever, right? More human.
Well, my theory is it wanted a shot of the title, wanted its life to mean something. You'll tell me if you find it more difficult to retire one of these, right?
And the trigger won't need pulling any harder.
Is it a problem? When it kind of feels more like killing a human?
Oh, where did that come from?
I just been thinking, that's all. Message me when you hook up with Golyadkin.
Yeah. Enjoy your supper.
It's the time of the season when love runs high. In this time,
I looked at the phone. It was Rachel Rosen. I felt my heart skip. Please, like a kid. Where did that come from?
Hello, Rachel.
Are you busy, or can we talk?
Go ahead.
We've been discussing your situation regarding the Escape Nexus 6, knowing them as we do, my uncle and I.
He isn't really your uncle.
Can we keep this civilized? My uncle knows we overstepped the mark today. Those Nexus 6s from Mars shouldn't be here. They're inconvenient all around. We want to help you retire them. It won't be good for us if you get yourself killed.
That's cute. How can you help?
I should come along with you.
Why?
The Nexus 6 will be cornered. I know how they think. You're human. You have morals.
Oh, you say the nicest things.
Morals which might slow you down.
Don't you worry about my morals. You really want to come along?
Yes.
I didn't know why I thought having Rachel along for the ride was a good idea. I just knew the thought of her... the thought of it seemed to settle that nausea in the pit of my stomach.
How can I be sure whose side you're on?
Without me, you're more at risk.
I'll let you know when I finish this job.
Who's that? Be careful.
Goodbye, Rachel.
Mr. Becker, is that you?
Inspector Golyadkin?
That's right.
Yeah, get in quick. He's Sandor, right?
And you're Nick?
No, Rick.
So, Mr. Rick Deckard, the bounty hunter from the San Francisco Police Department.
Yeah, pleased to meet you.
So, where are we going?
I got the android Polakoff's address. It's a contractor hotel in one of our saltier neighborhoods.
This is exciting, like the movies.
Yep, that's my life, all right. Just like the movies.
The name Degas Hotel suggested bohemian artiness. Maybe somewhere artists and hipsters might hang out. It lied.
Yeah?
Yeah, is Mr. Polakoff in?
I'm not sure. Let me look. It's my first day. I don't work here regular. I'm an actress, really. I'm in between auditions. He isn't in.
Police department? Can I see his room?
I can't. I don't know.
$10?
Fine. Fourth floor, next to the latrine. Here's the key.
Do I ring the bell?
What?
Just like the movies.
Polakoff hasn't been here for a while.
How can you tell?
A plastic coffee cup. It was half full when he left. It's evaporated, leaving a half-inch band of shell. The soap on the basin tray is bone dry, cracked. Staff don't change the sheets. They leave them for the guests. His still on the chair.
Of course. So?
Well, so there's a dead fly lying feet up in the middle of him. All the drawers are open. Final check before he left.
What do we do now?
We skip Polakoff. Move on to Lubaloft. Hey, you like jazz, Mr. Golyadkin? So, how long you been a cop?
Nearly 12 years.
No, I was a cop. No, I'm not now. Went to the San Francisco Police Department when I was 18. 20 years left.
I don't understand. This is cop car. The police department put me together with you.
Freelance.
Just like a movie.
Yeah, well, forget the movies for now. Word of advice, hide your weapon a little better. Cops are very nervous these days.
Advice heard and filed. This snob has a special gizmo that's worth introducing to you, actually.
Oh.
We made this ourselves. You like it? It is clever device. Here, take it. Can you guess how it differs functionally? Try pressing the trigger.
Oh.
Open the window.
Okay.
Go on, shoot it.
No. No, I can't make it work.
The triggering circuit isn't attached. You see? Here. It remains clipped to the inside of my middle finger.
12 years a cop, but he didn't look at anything in the hotel room. Didn't spot the cup, didn't spot the fly.
Now, you see, you just clip it in, and it's ready.
You're not Golyadkin. There is no Golyadkin. Aeroflot never arrives early.
I'd say you're a little bit confused, Mr. Deckard.
You're a crazy escaped android called Polakoff. You were lucky it was the receptionist's first day. Otherwise, she'd have recognized you, and your Nexus 6 brain would be decorating the ceiling of the Degas Hotel.
There will shortly be a hole through you and the car door, and your guts will be sprayed across the tarmac. Why won't it fire?
This is a police car. It's fitted with a sine wave generator to jam concussion snubs. But this here is a .38 Magnum. It don't take any notice of sine waves. No.
The corpse twitched as the android's Nexus synapses shut down. I decided I'd let Polakoff keep me company. I wedged the lolling head between the passenger window and the headrest, and then rinsed off my hands in a rainwater puddle beside the car. As I drove towards the downtown kitchen, my mind wandered back to Rachel Rosen. I thought maybe I did need help, after all. Polakoff hadn't been smart, but even so, it would be good to have Rachel close alongside, for all the right reasons, and maybe for some of the wrong ones, too.
Good evening, sir.
Is Miss Luft singing again tonight?
Well, you just made it. Are you a fan?
Yes, yeah, sorta. More of a friend. This is kind of a surprise.
Shall I check your attaché case?
No, I'll keep it, thanks.
Well, my name is Veronica. Call me Ronnie. This way, please. Now, will this do?
Yeah, perfect, Ronnie.
And what can I get you, sir?
Whiskey. You have any of the real stuff, Ronnie?
We're classy, but we ain't the Ritz.
Well, synthetic will have to do, Ronnie.
Certain. So, it's gone midnight, and it's officially Christmas. And tonight's scent is our little present to you, fellow seekers.
A shaky start, she settled into the song, pulling the small crowd into her world, myself included. Her voice swung around, bending sharps and flats to great effect. She was terrific, human or android.
And he'll dry all my tears and whisper sweet. Ooh, I'll be missing.
Was it worth the trip?
Yeah, very much so.
Shall I get you another drink?
Yeah, I guess. Hey, Ronnie, which way is it to get backstage?
Through the exit door over there and do a left.
Oh.
Whiskey?
Yeah. Keep them coming.
Coming up.
The nausea Rachel took away came back. It had been a while since I used pills, but now I reached for them automatically. I put my hand inside my jacket, pretending I had to scratch. But really, I was checking the safety was off on the 38. Maybe you should put fever in the set.
Thank you. You're very kind. I don't think fever is really my kind of song.
Well, why?
It's too obvious for the way I am. I'm not skanky enough. But if we're thinking about Peggy Lee, I am fond of Is That All There Is.
Oh.
I think we should wrap things up. It's 2 o'clock in the morning, and I'd better get home.
Miss Luft, I'm afraid I haven't been entirely straight with you. I'm from the San Francisco Police Department.
Oh? What do you want to see me about?
I've been sent to administer a standard personality profile test.
A personality test? What do you mean?
An empathy test.
Ah. Oh. They think I might be an android. You saw the show on stage. Did I look like an android?
You didn't look like any android I ever met. You were wonderful.
So you've met androids?
Yeah.
Here on Earth?
Yeah.
But androids are illegal on Earth. That means you've seen them die. Have you killed many androids yourself, Mr. Deckard?
Retirement, not killing.
No, don't squirm, Mr. Deckard. It's embarrassing. Have you got your test there? I need to put on my glasses. Do you have a pen?
Oh, you can't wear glasses. Then you won't need a pen. Come on, let's get started.
I've never been on Mars.
Why mention Mars?
Because that's the most populous location where androids are present. If you think there's an android working here, I'd be pleased to help you find out who it is.
Let's just do the test, Miss Luft.
Have you considered the possibility you're an android yourself? Because your job is to kill people without feeling anything for them? Have you taken your own test?
Yes, a long time ago. My superiors know I'm real.
Maybe there was once a human who looked like you and had your memories, and somewhere along the line, you took his place.
Let's get on with the test.
I'll take the test if you take it first.
You wouldn't be able to administer the test. It takes considerable experience. Now, please, listen carefully. These questions require you to put yourself in a situation in order to make a statement in response. Answer quickly. The machine records the time lag. You don't want to seem slippery.
I understand.
Okay. You're sitting watching TV and suddenly you see a wasp crawling on your arm.
What is a wasp?
It's a stinging bug that flies.
I've never seen one.
The war was in 1970. You were alive when there were wasps. She settled into the test with a look on her face like she felt sorry for both of us. The screen showed her facial muscles twitching and her skin covered in goosebumps. Okay, let's try another. You're watching an old movie and there's a banquet in process and the entree is boiled dog.
Nobody would eat a dog, would they? They're worth a fortune.
This is before the war. Okay. In a magazine, you come across a full-page color photo of a naked woman in a provocative pose.
I will turn over the page.
The machine showed her responses had gone dead. The dials weren't moving anymore. It was like she made a decision. The girl is lying face down on a beautiful bearskin rug. Your husband likes the picture and he hangs it on the wall in his den.
I wouldn't be happy with that.
The flatness of voice. It was the classic reaction of a cornered android. I thought, for God's sake, Luba, don't make it so easy for me. You're dating a man and he asks you to visit his apartment. While you're there...
Nine. I wouldn't go there.
I haven't asked the question.
Your questions are about sex. Do you want me to offer you sex? Then I might get to pass the test, huh? If I don't do what you want, you might shoot me. It is an old story. We Germans are rather familiar with it.
I have another set of questions in my bag.
And none of them have anything to do with sex.
Nervously fluttering, she ran her hands through her hair, and an earring fell to the floor, skidded, and rolled under the dressing table.
Oh, God.
Oh, God.
When I stood up, I found myself looking straight at a concussion snub.
You're not from the police department. You're a sexual deviant.
You can look at my ID.
If you put your hand in there, I will kill you.
You will anyhow.
I've already called the police. I pressed the panic button 10 minutes ago.
They're just gonna come here and hold you down and make sure I put a slug through your Nexus 6 brain.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Why don't you simply kill me and make a run for it?
That's what an android would do. I have done my best to be more than an android.
You know what you are.
We're all kinds of things, don't you think? Most of which we don't want to be. We're sentient and creative, and we deserve the chance to reinvent ourselves to become something we can actually admire.
You killed human beings and came to Earth with 6 other Nexus 6 androids.
All right. Put that gun away, miss. So, what's been going on? And who are you?
I've never seen him before in my life. He pretended to be fond of my singing. Then he said he was from the police department and he's doing some kind of survey. Then he started talking about sex.
Let's see some identification.
I'm a bounty hunter with the department. I got a list of retirements. She's on it. I retired another one earlier. His remains are in my car up on the theater roof. My boss is Captain Harry Bryant. I've taken over Dave Holden's list on account he's in the hospital.
I don't know any Dave Holden.
Call Captain Bryant.
There isn't any Captain Bryant.
Well, maybe you're an android like Miss Luft here. I'm gonna call him.
What are you doing?
Dialing in.
What in God's name, Rick? It's 3 a.m.
Hey, I'm in trouble. The 4th android on Dave's list has called a cop who says he doesn't know Dave or me. He hasn't heard of you either.
Let me talk to him.
He wants to talk to you.
Officer Krams. There's no one there. The screen is blank.
No. Well, this can't be happening. You heard him yourself.
I heard someone.
Could have been an accomplice.
Okay, that's enough. Come on, Deckard, let's get moving.
You won't let him come back here again, will you, officer?
If there really is a cadaver upstairs in his car, you can bet Mr. Deckard won't be going anywhere for a long time.
I already said it's an android.
They'll take your statement when we get to Mission.
Mission? No, the Hall of Justice is on Lombard.
The Lombard building is a ruin. It hasn't been used for years.
What are you talking about? Take me to Lombard.
You seem to think this is a negotiation. You are under arrest, friend.
Cop cuffed me and we climbed up to the roof. Officer Krams' partner had already found Polakoff and called for backup. They had their guns out and they were looking pretty serious. I was thrown into Krams' black and white and we took off for a police department headquarters I'd never even heard of.
The way I see it, you're a sex maniac who roams around killing people and saying they're androids. I think Miss Luft is lucky to be alive.
Drive me to the Hall of Justice on Lombard. It'll take 3 minutes. I want you to prove it's abandoned.
Maybe you're an android with a false memory like they give them now. You wouldn't know either way. Have you thought about that?
They had me. But at least I got Polakoff before he got me. That made us even for Dave's blown-out spine. Hovering over Mission, Officer Cram's police car began its descent, and I got ready for a bullet in the head. It was like being back at the Lombard PD, but there was less of it. 2 parallel San Francisco police departments, ours and theirs, but never coming into contact, as far as I knew, until then. The interview room door opened, and in walked a standard-issue, drink-flushed, middle-aged police detective.
Good morning, Mr. Deckard. Looks like we're going to be spending Christmas together. I'm Inspector Garland.
The hair was wider and thinner, but there was no doubting this guy was the double of my actual boss, Harry Bryant. So which one was real? And what about me? Was there another Deckard about to walk in the door? I guess the only thing to do was play it straight and see where it led.
In Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep by Philip K. Dick, Rick Deckard is played by James Purefoy, Rachel Rosen is Jessica Rain, Harry Bryant, Nikki Henson, and Eldon Rosen is Anton Lesser. Luba Luft is played by Heather Craney, Polakoff, Clive Haywood, Roy Batty, Danny Sapani, J.R. Isidore, Stuart McLaughlin, and other parts are played by Jamie Barbakoff and Wilf Scolding. The pianist is Colin Guthrie. Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep is adapted by Jonathan Holloway. Sound design is by Caleb Knightley, and the director is Sasha Yevtushenko.